saddle of lamb. I love this dish. And it's great when you've got a table of six, table of eight, because it's just the perfect main course. That looks incredibly elegant, but it's so straightforward and very sexy. And every chef in Britain loves making customers feel sexy. I'm gonna make the stuffing. First thing I'm gonna do is take the water out of the mushrooms. Non-stick pan, olive oil, piping hot. And the most important thing about these mushrooms is taking the water out. If we don't take the water out now, the stuffing in the centre of the lamb is gonna get all watery. So, the mushrooms, we've got shiitake, and we've got some oyster mushrooms there. Even button mushrooms are nice as well, but put some flavour into them, and then just season it lightly. A little bit of salt and pepper. Look at the colour on those mushrooms now. And the more colour you put into a mushroom, the more flavoursome it is. Okay, so I'm gonna take them out of the pan and put them into a colander, because I just want them to sort of cool down in there and then drain. Any water that's left inside that mushroom will come out, so therefore it's better that it goes in the bowl than it does in the stuffing. Okay, spinach, olive oil, nice and hot, butter into the center, and then get your spinach and just put the spinach straight in there. Straight in there, because what we're gonna do now is just wilt the spinach. Not cook it completely, just wilt it. Again, light seasoning, salt and pepper. Don't get precious with it, just turn it around. 30 seconds, out, and then on top of the mushrooms. And then just mix them up together. And when it's piping hot like that, I'm just gonna add a little bit of nutmeg. Nice fine grate. And all this does now is just perfumes the spinach. And again, it's a lot better to do it when it's hot. Okay, I'm gonna put the mascarpone cheese in there now. I use this cream cheese for lots of things. It's rich and it gives a great texture to a stuffing, and it just makes it a little bit more sort of luxurious. Cream it at the side of the bowl and just soften it a little bit. It almost melts it. And then I'm gonna start folding the cream cheese in to the mushrooms and the spinach, and then sort of be a little bit more vigorous and just give it a really good whip. I'm just gonna put an egg yolk in there, and that sort of helps bind the filling. Egg yolk in. Into the fridge to set, and it doesn't set sort of solid firm, it just goes almost like butter. Now, saddle of lamb sounds a little bit boring. Everyone's used to these posh cuts, aren't they? The sort of best end of lamb, you know, lamb chops, but they've forgotten about the saddle. For me, it's the most sort of delicious part. Not only is it sort of connected to the rump, which is here, the arse, there's the saddle there, on the back there. Now, that's what it looks like. That's the saddle there, boom, big, big saddle of lamb. And you've got the loin there, and these beautiful little fillets, which is the sort of chef's dream, the Rolls Royce of lamb. It looks quite intimidating because it's got the bone in there, but don't worry about the bone. Get the butcher to take the bone out, and that's what you're gonna be left with. There's the two loins. There's the little beautiful lamb fillets. I'm gonna get a bulb of garlic. Just cut it in half, salt and pepper. And what this does now, it actually gets the garlic to bleed. Take all the juice out of the garlic and just leave it sitting there for the next 2 or 3 minutes. Now, I'm gonna use sage for the center of the saddle of lamb. If you can't get hold of sage, use some rosemary or some thyme. Line the lamb with the sage. And what this starts to do now is actually perfume the lamb as it's roasting in the center. And be quite generous with it. Okay, then I take my garlic. It started to go a little bit wet on top because the salt started to draw out all that juice. This is a way of being a little bit more discreet with garlic and a little bit more sort of clever with it, and it just stops it from becoming obtrusive. So you can have a snog after dinner without having to think that someone stinks of garlic and get away with it. Okay, I'm gonna get the stuffing. That's nice and chilled now. Use your fingers and just get the filling and be quite sort of firm with it. I'm just gonna get my lamb fillets like this and just go down the center and just open that up. Okay, once that's open there like that, just place that on top of the lamb. And then again, with the other fillet, just open it up, make a little incision, then just use your fingers. It's so soft, it almost sort of cuts itself. And then again, place that on top. Bring one of the flaps halfway over and just sort of fold it nicely. And then, the other flap, fold over nicely. Now, just put a little bit of olive oil on your sage leaves. Get the leaf and just stick it over that hole. And that stops any filling from coming out. Now we're going to tie it. We don't want the string rolling around everywhere, so we always stick the string inside a pan. So I'm just going to go round like this, over, and then just tie that simple knot just in the middle, like that. Don't cut it, because we need that little bit there, because we're going to get that little bit there, and we're just going to slide that underneath the lamb and come back to this end. Now, pull the string up, form a loop like this. That's it, one simple loop, and then put that over your saddle of lamb. Then just pull it. Not too tight, because that will force more of the stuffing coming out of the lamb. Up again, up, form a loop, and over. And then just pull it nice and gently. And it does look like it's sort of, you know, a chef-y thing, but it's just having the confidence. String, loop, and over. Now, you can do individual knots, but you're going to be there all day. This just takes 2 or 3 minutes. And once you've learned the way of sort of doing a simple knot, then doing the same with a stuffed chicken leg, or whether you're doing a fillet of beef, it's exactly the same. Right to the very end. So, that's my first piece. All I'm going to do now is just pull that one back up, make sure my sage leaf is there, and then just tie that, again, in a very simple knot. And now, look, it looks like a little glamorous sort of parcel, ready to take to the party. You can actually do it the day before, even 2 days before. Don't worry about that and get rid of the stress. Now, we're going to roast it. Touch of olive oil in there. The garlic that we used to flavour the inside of the lamb. And these stalks of sage, use them, because that's going to create a little bit of sort of bed for the lamb to sit on when it's roasting in there. Now, season the lamb first. Salt and pepper. Again, just do it on the board and roll everything in there. In to your pan and just start getting some colour. And this dish is at its best when it's served between sort of pink and medium. Can't really serve it sort of rare because you won't get the true flavour of the lamb. Now we're starting to colour the lamb, I'm going to put some butter in there. As that goes in there, it's going to create a really nice froth. And the froth is what gives the lamb a really nice flavour. Seal it at both ends as well. Okay, now look at that colour. Place the sage and the garlic in the centre. Okay, now I'm just going to lift the lamb up and sit it on top of the sage. And there you go. The oven's on sort of 190, 200. It's going to go straight in there now. Nice hot oven.
And cook it for an hour.
Most important thing now is just to leave it there. Don't take the string off. And for goodness sake, do not cut it. If you cut it now when it's piping hot, you've lost the goodness in the lamb. We want them, our guests, to eat the goodness. Okay, it's rested for 10 minutes. Just cut through the string, and then just peel it off. Again, be very, very careful when you do this, because it's stuffed, it's still slightly in danger of bursting open. So just be very gentle when you pull the string. Now, we're not gonna go thin, little, silly slivers. Nice, big, thick, chunky slices. If you slice it too thin, it goes stone cold. Then it loses its texture. So nice, big, thick, delicious steaks. Look, beautiful. That fat is nice and crispy. You can identify the stuffing. That is a dish on its own. You've got the spinach, you've got the mushrooms, you've got the sage inside, and it is delicious. That's the way to serve lamb.